Welcome to the video lecture on causal and non-causal systems. In this video, we'll consider an example, a continuous time system, which is represented as y of t is equal to x of t into cosine of t plus 1. The task is to determine, is this system causal or non-causal? To begin with, the definition of causality says that a system is said to be causal if its output at any time depends on present or the past values of the inputs only. It never depends on future values. By any chance, if it depends on any of the future values, we clearly say that the given system is non-causal or anti-causal. So we'll consider this example. Say for example, I want to find the value of the output y of t at t equal to 1. So let me put t equal to 1 in that expression. So I get y of 1 is equal to x of 1 into cosine of 2. So I said the value of the output at any time should depend on present or the past value. So I'm trying to find the value at t equal to 1, which is the present value of the input. To find this, I should know x of 1, which is again the present value of the input. So I can say that the given system is causal system. It is not depending on any of the future values. Hence, it is clearly a causal system. But one may get a doubt on cos of t plus 1. Cos of t plus 1 is just a function. It is not related in any way to the input x of t. So cos of t plus 1 is completely a different value. So it doesn't play any role while determining the causality. So while determining the causality, we concentrate mainly on the input x of t and the output y of t. That's it. So rest we don't care. So hence I clearly say that the given system is causal.